Hello, everybody. Welcome into Talking Fitchburg on this Monday, January 4th, 2021. Jeremy Crosby here. Hope you had a wonderful weekend. Glad you're joining us for the first Talking Fitchburg of 2021. Let's set aside 2020, pretend like it never happened. What do you say? What do you say, Andrew? Yes, he says yes. Can people hear you?
Yes.
Now they can. Yes, they
Hi. Hi, everyone.
2020 was quite the year, Andrew. Go yes, down as the record books as something that may not be discussed for a long time after after a year like that. Changed everybody's lives, and it's still going on. It's not that I'm past it, but amazing when you think of the beginning of 2020 to the end, coming out with a vaccine on, you know, what seems like the worst pandemic ever.
Right.
Ay. But hey, you know what? We're here. We're ready to go. And another year here of Talking Fitchburg, Andrew. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm ready to start. Here we go.
And just so you're aware, the kid, you know, my kids, they're still in the picture. So.
Oh, yeah. They're happy about it, too.
Yeah, Carson... He's just throwing his head back and going, ah.
Having a good time.
And my daughter is standing on a rocking chair. So that's what's going on in the Crosby household. Get down from the chair there, sweetie. Thank you.
Nice.
Quarantine, as I do the show. Gotta love it. All right. We have a very busy show for you today. And we're going to talk about taxes. Yeah, you haven't, if you haven't learned about the taxes and everything related to your property taxes, we have that information for you today. So we'll get that coming up here in just a few seconds. There's me pointing, saying shush. And we got your headlines for you as well. And that's where we're going to start the show. And we start about tax collection, a couple of changes. I want to make sure to get the information out to you. As it came with your tax bill, the tax insert, which is at the bottom right of your screen, it says this, that in-person payment location change is now located in the community center. So if you come for in-person to pay your property taxes, you're paying those by going over to the community center. But before you do that, you need to make an appointment. They're only accepting by appointment only this year. So if you need to pay in-person, you need to make an appointment. You go to the website, fitchburgwi.gov, and then you can find the information there that you need to get logged in and set on the appointment book. If you're coming in just to drop off your property tax bill, that can be dropped off in the foyer in City Hall. So, or you probably could even hand it to the ladies in the community center as well. Whatever works, right? But we are doing this because of COVID, trying to keep everybody's workspace open and clear. So that's why we're over in the community center doing that work this year. So that is the information I have on that. All right, recycling your holiday lights. Yes, if you're about to get rid of those lights for the year, got a good way to keep them on the landfill here. For those holiday lights not working anymore, you can bring them out to City Hall. There's a special cart located in the foyer 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's at 5520 Lacey Road in Fitchburg. Residents can drop off their non-working string holiday string lights and extension cords for recycling. Residents must remove any bulbs larger than marble size and recycle those separately. So keep that in mind when you're bringing out those strands of lights. Also, holiday tree collection started this week. It goes this week, and you will have another chance. So if you missed it already, you got another chance here. But have those trees out on the curb, not in the street, at 6:30 a.m. on the Monday of the collection week. This week runs through January 9th. Next one is Monday, January 18th. Through Saturday, January 23rd for holiday tree pickup. So keep that in mind as you're discarding those holiday trees. All right, finally here, the BBB has some tips, 5 resolutions for fraud-free New Year. I like these. Let's go right into these tips here. One, I resolve to be cautious with emails. Be on guard if you receive unsolicited emails from a person or company. Remember that the scammer can make emails look like they're from a legitimate business, government agency, or representative organization. Never click on a link. If you don't believe it, it's probably fake. It's as easy as that. Next one for you here. It's this. I resolve to never, never send money to strangers. If you haven't met a person face-to-face, don't send them the money. This is especially true if the person asks you to wire money or transfer funds using prepaid debit cards. Don't do it. Please. Please. I'm begging you. You have to, if they request to pay by I need this, you know, I need this prepaid card or something. Don't do it. Not good. Probably not legit, and you're not going to get that money back. Do the research before making the online payments and purchases. You got to do your research, folks. Make sure they are a legit business and you trust them. And we've got this as well. Use your best judgment when sharing personal information. Sensitive information includes banking and credit card information, your birth date, your address, your phone number, social security card, insurance information. Never share this information out on the old web there. And yeah, social media, smart folks. Keep those privacy settings on and think before you post. You got to do that. All these tips and all the stories we talked about today, we'll share links so you can check out more information. All right, that does it for us here on our Talking Fitchburg headlines. Coming up next, we open up our guest segment, two-parter today. We're talking with Misty Dodge about your property taxes. That's next right here on Talking Fitchburg.